In researching what work schedule small businesses were using, I saw so many variations, but I finally decided on creating a schedule where the hours to be worked can be seen by day, and then each sheet in the workbook would contain the schedule for the full week. So here's how I built it. So in cell A1, I'm going to type the starting date of the work week that we're going to reflect in this calendar. And for this example, that's going to be November the 5th, 2023. Next, placing my cursor back in that cell to make it the active cell, I want to format the date so that it displays the day of the week and the calendar day. Again, without leaving this cell, in your home tab, go to the number section, and here in the drop-down, we're going to select long date. And next, I need to add a column for each business hour in which I need to staff. So my business is going to be open from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. So starting in cell B2, I'm going to type 8 a.m., type 9 a.m. in cell C2, and then I'm going to select these two cells and drag down to autofill the remaining hours of the work week. So when I get to the last hour, which in this example is 9 p.m., I will let go of my cursor and let's highlight all these and double click to expand. And FYI, I'm doing this in hour blocks. Your calendar can just as easily be done in half hour or even 15 minute increments. So my hours here along the top are formatted how I want them to be formatted. Now, in the off chance that yours are not, select them. And with the hours selected, right click and go to format cells. Here, go into time, into the time category, and make sure you've selected the option that says 1:30 p.m. And this is going to ensure that your time is displayed in a 12-hour format and also show the a.m., p.m. in the end. So click OK once you have that. So next, in the cell just after my final time slot for the day, I want to include a total column so that I can see how many hours each employee is working that day. So for now, we'll just type the word total here in this cell. So the reason I began typing the hours to be staffed in column B instead of column A is because I want to use column A to type the employee names. So your business obviously can have more or less employees, but for this example, I just have these 7 employees. So once you've entered the names of all your employees, we'll add borders to the calendar. And to do this, we'll select the entire area that we've just typed. And with that area selected, in your home tab in this font section, go to the borders dropdown and select all borders. Next, I know that I want to note when an employee is scheduled to work by typing an X in each time slot that they'll be scheduled to work. So to help each scheduled time slot stand out more, I'm going to add a conditional format that will apply color to the cell if it contains an X. So to do this, I'm going to select all of the cells that represent a time slot. So all of the cells in the area underneath the hour blocks. So in the Home tab, in the Style section, I'm going to go to Conditional Formatting. And here I'm going to select to highlight cell rules and we'll select equal to. And I want to say if the contents of the cell equals to X, then I want the following formatting. And you can use any of the presets here, but I want to use my own custom format, which is going to be an orange fill. So I'm going to come here to the fill section, and I'm going to select this orange. And click OK. And we can test that it works just by typing an X. So we'll type an X in this first cell, and now each time an X is typed or that a time slot has been assigned, we'll see that it changes color. So now in the total column, I want to, of course, see the total hours that each employee will be working that day. So to do this, I'm going to use the COUNTA function. Now COUNTA counts the number of cells with contents that are not numerical, which is what we want because we're using the letter X to designate if the employee will be working that time slot. So I'll type equals count day, open parentheses, and then select the entire row of time slots for that associate. Then close the parentheses. We'll copy and paste this down. Now, if your time slots are half an hour, you'll divide this by two. So you'll just come to the end of this function and add a slash two. Or if your time slots are in 15-minute increments, then you would instead divide by four. So if you're watching this tutorial, you probably have a small business with staff that you're trying to manage scheduling for. Now, while I think the calendar that we're creating here is pretty great, if you want an even simpler solution, you should try the sponsor of this video, Connect Team. They have a super easy to use app that you can use whether you're on desktop, your smartphone, or a tablet. You'll be able to create your team schedule in a breeze with their simple drag and drop feature. And then once you're done, your employees will be able to see their schedule along with key tasks right on their smartphone. They can even clock in and out right from the app. Plus, if you have 10 users or less, it's free to use, which is pretty amazing for something that can handle all of your HR needs. So make sure you reach out to them using the link in the description of this video so that they know that I sent you. And thank you, Connect Team, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. So next, we'll apply some formatting to this. So I'm going to bold the hours in the total column along with date field and all of the associate names. And actually, I think I want to bold the total hours for the week. Let's expand this to make sure it shows. I'm also going to select this entire section of cells along the top and merge all of this into one long cell. So with all of these selected, I can do this in the Home tab by going to the Alignment section. And here, there's an option for Merge and Center, so I'm going to click that. And actually, I think I want to add a little bit of color to this. Let's select the same orange. Then I want to go into more colors because I want it to be just a little bit lighter. We'll use this color. And for now, let's just delete this example X that we entered earlier. One more thing I want to do is select this section of cells again where we'll be entering the X's. And I actually want to center this right in the cell. So our X's are centered. And this is just formatting because I like for it to look a certain way. So now that we have the first week created and formatted, I'm going to select all of it and using Control C on my keyboard, I'm going to copy it and then use Control V to paste it just below it. And now here on the date field, I'm going to reference the original date. So type an equal sign and select the cell with the first workday. And then I'm just going to type plus one so that now I'll know that this next box is going to be for the next workday. So now with this done, I can copy and paste this five more times to complete the work week. So again, using Control C to copy it and Control V to paste it just below it. And my work week started on a Sunday, so I'm going to end on the following Saturday. So now that the calendar has been created for each day, I want to assign a name to each day. And the reason I'm doing this is because in this example, I have seven associates, and even with that, I have to scroll to see the other days. You may have a lot more associates than this. And by using a name for each, we'll be able to just jump to it by selecting it. So to do this, I'm going to select all of the cells for that first Sunday. And here in this top box, I'm going to type Sunday. And when you're done typing the name, just press Enter. I'm going to do the same thing for Monday. Do the same thing for Tuesday. And we'll do this for each day of the week. So I did this so I can scroll and get to the other day a little bit faster. So what you would do is click on that drop down, and let's say we want to go to Saturday, select Saturday, and now you'll jump directly to that day. And if you need to make any changes to these name fields, you're going to do that in the Formulas tab of your ribbon, and then go to the Define Name section and click on Name Manager. Here you'll see all of the names in that in your workbook, and you can, edit, delete, make any changes as you need. So something else I'd like to see in this worksheet is the total number of hours that each employee is working for the full week. Let's make this smaller so we have a little more room. So I'm just going to do that over here on the side of the work schedule. So this will have two columns, and the first one will be employee. The next one will be total hours for the week. Let's bold these two. So next, below employee, I want to type all of the employee names. Now, this needs to be exactly as they appear on the schedule. And actually, to avoid any errors, I'm going to copy these and then paste these. I'm going to use paste value so they're not bolded under the employee header that we just created. And the reason that we need for this to be exact is because if there is any variation, any extra space or anything, formula that we're going to use to calculate the total hours worked is not going to work. And that formula is going to be the sum if function. So we'll type equals sum if, and for the range, we're going to select the column with all the names, which we actually can't do. It should be column A, but because my first cell is merged, it wants to highlight the entire work schedule. So I'm going to just fix this here and replacing that last letter with just A. So now I'm referencing all of the cells in column A. And this is the range that the sum if function is going to search through. So for the criteria, we'll select the employee name that we typed here. And what this will do is it will look for this name in column A. So then once we've done that, we'll add a comma. And then for the sum range, we want to select the final column, which again, like before, it wants to select everything. And so, but I know that the total column is in column P. So we'll say P to select only that column. And then with that, we'll press enter. And now we'll just copy this down to the other employees. And let's add borders to this also. So let's test this. Let's say we want on Sunday for John to come in and work from, let's say, 8 to 1. Okay, so we see this here. He's working 6 hours on Sunday. Fine. And then he's got 6 hours here. So then let's say he comes 8 to 1 on Monday as well. Okay, so this is working as we want. So 6 hours each day, total of 12 hours for the week. So let's make sure other employees have the same thing. So let's say we want Henry to work from 2 to 9. That's 8 hours. And then same thing on Monday. So perfect. So 8 hours each day. So this is now working the way we want. Now, one more thing that I want to do to the total hours worked for the week is add a conditional format because, again, the reason I created this section is to try to avoid accidentally scheduling someone for overtime, especially since my budget doesn't really allow for that. So I'm going to go to conditional formatting and highlight cell rules. This time I'm going to choose greater than. And we're going to say greater than 40. So that means if an employee works 40 hours, it's not going to be flagged. But if they work 41 hours, we're going to see this flagged. And for this example, I'm just going to keep the light red fill with the dark text. Now, let's say just for fun, let's make Sasha work some overtime. So we'll schedule her for 9 hours. And we'll do this. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And that should push her into overtime. And yep, this is flagging that we scheduled her for 45 hours. So then we can just delete an extra hour each day to push her back down to 40. And now we no longer see that flagged. So next, I want to do some formatting so that I can print this and hang this on a break room wall. The first thing I'm going to do. So I'm going to add a header to it. So let's actually switch our view to the page layout view. And I like this view because I can see the headers and footers on it. So I'm going to label this. I'm going to put it in all caps, team work schedule. And then below it, I'm going to reference the tab name. And we'll update that in just a minute. But by tab name, I mean the sheet name. So whenever you're in the header or footer section, you're going to see a header and footer tab show up in your ribbon. So in that tab, I'm going to select sheet name. And before I exit this, I also want to come to bold this. So back in the home tab, I'm going to click bold and we'll make this just a little bit bigger. Okay, and now just click anywhere to get out of this. And actually, let's make it just a bit smaller. So we have teamwork schedule along the top. So rather than have it display sheet one, I'm going to right click on the tab and rename the sheet. So this will be week of 11-5 to 11-11-2023. And now this shows at the top. So because my sheet defaults to a portrait view, I actually need to change this to print horizontally. So back in the page layout view, in the page setup section, click on orientation and select landscape. So here I can see that now my sheet is printing horizontally. Now from here, it's honestly just a lot of playing with this. Oh, one thing, I don't necessarily need to print the total hours for the week that each associate is going to work. So I'm going to, let me make this smaller so you can see it. I'm going to select all of the calendar days because this is what I want to print. So all the way down to the last day with all of that selected. Still in the page layout tab of my ribbon, I'm going to go to print area and set the print area. So now when I go to print, this isn't going to print with the work schedule, which is fine because I just need that for myself. So from here, it's really just some playing around with it. I'm actually going to just switch my view again. And this time I'm going to go to the page break preview. And then the page break preview, each of these blue lines represents a page break. So now I'm going to just drag this all the way to the end. And that's going to force all of the hours to print together. Now I need to do some more maintenance to make sure that no days get cut off. So for example, here you see that there's a page break right below the work hour. So we don't want that. So I'm going to just bring this up. And actually, why don't I just do Sunday through Wednesday in one page, and then page two will have the remainder of the days. So you have to be a little cognizant when you do this, because one thing that's going to happen is in order for Excel to force these new print areas, it's going to have to shrink everything onto the sheet. And we can see that. So we'll go back to the page layout tab and under page setup, and I click this and you'll see that it adjusted it to 60% of normal size. Now I'm okay with that. But if you want it to be bigger, there are certain things you can do to play with it. Let's go back to a normal view. So we did 1 week. Now, if you want to do subsequent weeks, you can just come down here to the tab, right-click on it, and select Move or Copy. And we're just going to create a copy of this tab. You can move it to the end or to the front. I like the newer tabs to the front. And then we'll update the days on this one. So this will be November the 12th to November the 18th, 2023. And we'll change this up here. 11-12 is the first day of the week. We can clear all of these. And I'm just selecting these and deleting. Lastly, I want to check if these names are still working like I wanted to. So let's just randomly select Thursday. And yeah, it went right to the new Thursday for that tab. I can check my print preview in the page layout section. Click on print preview. And yeah, it's printing 11-12 to 11-16 and everything still looks how I wanted it. So you can now go in and assign shifts as you need to. Thanks for watching. And for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.